New at 10, medical marijuana will soon be available all over Missouri. Advocates promise it will improve the lives of countless sick people.
But contaminated marijuana can kill you. So how will patients know it's safe?
News 4 investigator Lauren Traeger gets you the answers.
Amidst oil fields and near roaming cows, in this unassuming industrial building in Oklahoma City.
This big peak here is for THC.
High-tech tests on cannabis.
I've got a doctorate in inorganic and analytical chemistry.
Owner of Fast Labs, Kyle Felling, doesn't believe in wearing white coats. But in this small old office space, he says these few employees are saving lives.
I like to look at myself as the person that helps ensure that a patient gets something that's not going to make them sick.
Tainted or contaminated marijuana is real. Documented cases show people getting sick or dying from it.
Because medical marijuana is still illegal on the federal level, it is not regulated by the FDA. So that means it's left up to the states to decide if the plants or products will be tested. Oklahoma, for example, did not require testing when it first passed its law. That's a mistake Missouri did not intend to repeat.
Safety to Missourians is our utmost concern, and so all those things would be tested.
Lyndall Fraker is head of Missouri's up-and-coming medical marijuana program. There will be at least two private testing sites for marijuana in the Show Me State.
We certainly want to see a safe product for Missourians, and I think that's going to be the most important thing, that what the product has labeled is what it is, and just like anything else. So we want to protect Missouri citizens.
So how exactly does the testing work? We went to Oklahoma City, to Kyle's lab, to find out.
Marijuana is the catfish of the plant kingdom, is the way I like to say it. So anything it comes into contact with, it soaks up.
The problem, experts say, isn't the cannabis, but what it can contain.
What you can get sick from would be lead poisoning, or mercury poisoning, or poisoning from a pesticide that a grower hasn't properly cleaned off of their plants.
Samples are brought in from growers and product manufacturers.
This is a high-pressure liquid chromatograph.
Then tested to see if they're safe.
We commonly screen for 60 of the most common pesticides that are out there. We test for heavy metals like arsenic, cadmium, mercury, and lead. We test for mold, salmonella, E. coli.
One of the most common contaminants that they find is actually mold. You can see it right here on this. It's something that can make a sick person even sicker.
Mold, I find all the time.
The demand for testing is so high, Kyle says his lab is nearly overwhelmed.
Constantly, day and night.
Day and night.
Mm-hmm.
Like it never shuts down.
It never shuts down.
So this is going to be the lobby where patients will come in.
Dispensary owners scrambling to get up and running in Oklahoma say testing could make or break their business.
Testing is the most important part of the medical cannabis life cycle. As a business owner, I need to know what we're putting into each product. As a patient, I need to be able to go into a store and purchase products based on the ingredients of the cannabis, because all cannabis isn't grown the same. One might do something to me where another does something else to me. And so to be able to come in and see the test results is super important for a patient.
This bud tender, as he's known, at a dispensary downtown says most buyers simply want to know how much THC they're taking.
Normally they just typically ask, like, does it have the testing? And so then I would just answer them. And they typically are looking for terpenes and THC content.
Testing informs labels and keeps the product free from contaminants. Who will run the labs in Missouri? For now, only time will tell.
When Illinois' pilot medical marijuana program began a few years ago, they also mandated testing. We never heard back from facilities we contacted there. Patients in Missouri can start applying for medical marijuana cards on the 4th of July. We've got a lot more information for you about who qualifies and what the regulations will be on our website, KMOV.com. I'm Lauren Traeger, News 4 Investigates.